A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. As Jesus continued his journey to Jerusalem, he traveled through Samaria and Galilee. As he was entering a village, 10 lepers met him. They stood at a distance from him and raised their voices, saying, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." And when he saw them, he said, "Go show yourselves to the priests." And when he saw them, he said, Go show yourselves to the priests. As they were going, they were cleansed. And one of them, realizing he had been healed, returned glorifying God in a loud voice. And he fell at the feet of Jesus and thanked him. He was a Samaritan. Jesus said in reply, 10 were cleansed, were they not? Where are the other 9? Has none but this foreigner returned to give thanks to God?" Then he said to him, "Stand up and go. Your faith has saved you." The word of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. The first reading for this Sunday is very much related to the gospel. As usual, the church offers the first reading and the gospel as related to over a theme. And obviously the theme for today is gratitude. I recommend you to read the first reading and not only the verses that are in the lectionary, that is the reading as it is proclaimed on Sunday, but actually read the whole chapter 5 of the second book of Kings, because that story of Naaman is beautiful and we can learn a lot from it. And I'm sure the Holy Spirit will inspire you to learn several lessons from this beautiful passage in the Old Testament. Naaman was a general of the Assyrian army, I believe, and he was victorious. He was highly esteemed by his master. He was, I suppose, rich. He was courageous, but he was also a leper. In the Old Testament, leprosy is usually a symbol for us of sin. We can relate it to us. We may have many, many qualities. Many good qualities. We can be intelligent, we can be good looking, we can be kind, we can have beautiful human qualities, but still, each one of us, you and I, we are sinners and we are in need of God's mercy. And so we see in the healing of the lepers of Jesus in the gospel, we see how these 10 lepers who, because of their illness, were cast out of society, they cried out to Jesus and they asked for him to have pity. And in the Old Testament, this general, knowing that he was sick, he went to look for the man of God and he wanted to be healed, to receive healing from this man of God. And so he went all the way to Israel, to the land of Israel, to ask this favor from somebody who was not part of his religion. He was a pagan. He worshiped many other gods, but he came to this man of God, the God of Israel, asking for this favor of healing. That in both instances, they received a similar way of receiving healing. They both received a word from the man of God in the Old Testament from Elisha, in the New Testament from Jesus himself, and who told them, "Do this." And then they send them on their way. In the case of Naaman, the prophet, he didn't even came out to greet him. He sent a messenger. He sent one of his servants with the message to go to the Jordan River to bathe 7 times, and then he will be healed. And it says the reading that he turned around in anger because he had expectations. He knew how the man of God should have gone about the business of healing him. He thought that he's going to invoke his God, he's going to put his hand of my illness, and I'm going to be healed. So he had preconceived ideas of how the man of God should have acted towards him in order for him to receive healing. In other words, he wanted to tell God how God was supposed to work this miracle for him. And how many times we ourselves, we don't like what the people, the prophets of God, in this case priests and maybe some consecrated people, or maybe even just a fellow Christian, tells us what we need to do because we want God to act on us and to work miracles for us, but we want him to do it in our way and in our timetable. And so we get angry with God because he doesn't do our will on earth as it should be done in heaven. But then we see in the case of Naaman that it was his servants, his slaves, who approach him and they convince him from this place of humility. They talk to this proud man and they convince him, telling him, well, if the prophet had asked you to do something very different, very difficult, wouldn't you have done it? How much more that he asked you such a simple thing? Just do it and see what happens. Fortunately, this proud man, this general, this victorious general who was a leper, he listened to the voice of these little people who really count for nothing, his slaves, his servants. And he went to the river and he bathed according to the word of the man of God, and he received his healing. And not only healing from his leprosy, but also healing in his heart from his pride and from his attitude that God has to do the things the way I want him to do. He received a healing that made him humble and grateful. Naaman, after receiving the healing from the God of Israel, he says, I know there is no other God but in Israel, and I will not worship any other God. And any one of us who have received a great favor from God, this needs to be the attitude that we are willing to cast away all our idols, everything that we give our hearts to, everything that we worship in place of God, we cast them away and we say, I will not worship any other God except the God of Israel, which for in our case is the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the Blessed Trinity. And so we see a beautiful story in Naaman, this leper, and how God healed him. The point is this: he heard the command from the man of God. He was willing to let go of his expectations and just obey the word that he was given. And then he received his healing, doing a very simple thing according to the word of this man of God. And in the New Testament is the same thing. Jesus tells them very simply to these 10 lepers, go and show yourselves to the priest. That is not a very difficult thing to do. Go and show yourself to the priest. And on their way, they were cleansed. And then they said, when they realized that they were cleansed, one of them, who was a Samaritan, came back to Jesus and glorifying and praising God, and then he fell at his feet. There are several points that we can draw from here. As in the Old Testament, Jesus gives them a very simple command, and they obey. And in obeying this command of Jesus, then they receive their healing. In our Catholic Church, we as Catholics, the very simple command that the Lord gives us to rid of ourselves of sin is go to confession, show yourself to the priest. And then when we go to confession and we do this very simple ritual of confessing our sins and asking forgiveness from God, then he gives us our healing. He restores us in our heart, in our spirit. He restores in us the life of grace, the life of the Spirit. And that is a very simple command that he gives us. And we just need to do it, carry it out and receive this healing. And not only receive the healing, but again, after we have received the healing, we need to come back to Jesus and show him our gratitude. Now notice the leper is giving thanks to Jesus. And Jesus says, has anybody else except this foreigner come and give thanks to God? I think this is another instance where Jesus is asserting his divinity. He is not just another prophet. He is not just a moral teacher. He is God, and he asserted this one time and again in the gospel, that Jesus Christ is God, the Son of God, the Word of God made flesh. And so he accepts this worship from this Samaritan, and then he also asks us, you know, you can imagine him in the gospel turning around to you and say, have I not healed you? Have I not given you all these gifts? Where is your gratitude? How are you showing God gratitude for what he's giving you? Now, the best way for us to show gratitude to the Lord Jesus is to come and celebrate the Eucharist. The very word Eucharist means thanksgiving, giving thanks to God. And giving thanks to God together with Jesus, we united as the church, as the body of Christ, we come together on Sunday, and together as the body and the head, as Christ himself, we offer our thanksgiving to God, and we receive from him even more grace so that we can be able to live our lives as restored, as saved people. As the Lord said to the Samaritan, Go in peace, your faith has saved you. Not only receiving good gifts from God and by doing what he has commanded us to do, but after receiving them, coming in his presence and giving him thanks. And then we not only receive this favor and this healing and these wonderful things that the Lord does for us, but we also receive salvation when we give thanks to God, when we attend Holy Mass on Sunday. So with this reflection, I leave you today, and may God bless you and give you a heart full of thanks for all the many blessings that he has bestowed upon you, and a heart full of praise, and praise that recognizes and confesses Jesus as Lord, as Savior, as God, as Redeemer. Thank you, and God bless you. Arrivederci.